difference between rule instances and data instances. Look at here. If you open any rule, let me open any rule. Process correspondence. If I open correspondence rule, does it have seconds account? This rule is available in STFM, right? So that means STFM would have been applied with security checkbox. Let me open this. If you go ahead here, STFM is applied with security use checkout. So any rule that is available in this rule set will have check-ins account. Now, if you open property, data model property, here you go, another property here, any property. So property has check-ins account. What is the instance class of a property? Property is an instance of which class? Rule OBJ property. Just give me 1 minute. Now, property has this check-ins account and all. If similarly, if you open correspondence rules, if you open sections, section will also have check-ins account that we have seen. Section is an instance of which class? Rule HTML section, right? Now, let me open one of the rule called operator. Section is an instance of which class? Rule HTML section, right? Operator. If I open operator, operator is all is there in a state FMI class. If you open state FMI rule set, I'm sorry, this rule set has check-ins account applied. So any rule that is available in this rule set should have check-ins account being available. But is it is check-ins account available here in the rule form? This rule form doesn't have check-ins account button displayed. Still, it is there in a rule set which is secured with check-ins account process by selecting the checkbox. Operator is an instance of which class? Data dash, admin dash, operator dash, ID, but still it doesn't have check-ins account. Similarly, you open access group, does it have check-ins account? Access group is an instance of data admin operator access group class. Similarly, you open work group, you know work basket, work groups. Work group is an instance of data admin operator work group or work group. I'm not very much sure about the class, but it is there in a rule set which has check-ins account, but this rule form you will not see check-ins account. This is an instance of class data dash related classes. Similarly, if you open work basket, that means work queue in Pega 8. What is this? Does it have check-ins account? What is the instance class of work basket? What is the instance class of work basket? What is the instance class of work basket? Entity. What is the instance class of work basket?
Assign dash work basket.
Assign dash work basket purpose is what? Assign dash work basket is instance class of which class? Assign dash work basket is instance class of which one? So, I think this is not the one that I know first covered. Structured is to describe the information. So, this should be the instance class of work basket. Let me go ahead and show you another one. Embed dash data admin work basket. This is the actual instance class of work basket. Definition. Study. Operators work basket. So, this is instance class of work basket. Assign dash work basket is instance class of what?
Assignment.
That is not for work basket. Work basket is a rule, right? Separate rule. Work basket is instance of embed dash data admin work basket. So with this, you come across with one of the OTP topmost classes. What is the class? Ahmed Dash. You can go ahead and see data admin work basket also. I will check and let you know what is the difference between these two. This is related to work queue, I believe. The latest work baskets are updated to work queues, right? Data admin work basket updated, something it is saying. I'll find out, okay? So it's related to work queues. Now, let's go ahead and proceed forward and understand this difference between rule instances and data instances. One difference that we can see, the rules, all these are rules, whether it is a data instance or rule instance, generally call it as rules. Operator is a rule, property is a rule, section is a rule, work basket is a rule, work queue, I mean like work group is a rule, anything is a rule. Rules which are children of rule dash class. Rule dash class actually will not have instances. Rule dash child classes will be there. Rule obj property, rule HTML section, rule obj flow, rule obj flow action. If you look at some of the rules for which the parent classes will start with rule dash, all these rules when you open, you will see check in checkout option. So the rules which are having check in checkout option, but blindly looking at the rule form, you can understand those are rule instances. The rules which do not have check in checkout option are data instances. Data instances parent class will be ultimately entity data dash. Rule instances parent class could be rule dash, or we have code dash, all these are available. Maybe code dash have some instances, those may have check in checkout, right? I'm not very much sure about it, but still data instances parent class will be derived from data dash. Rule instances mostly derived from rule dash. Rule instances will have check in checkout. Data instances will not be having check in checkout. This is the difference between rule instances and data instances. What is the rule instances? What is the data instances? So here you go. Rule instances, parent class, that is top parent class. I have to say top parent class is rule dash. What about here? Top parent class is data dash. What about this one? Second point, these rules will be having check-in checkout. What about this one? These rules will not have check-in or checkout. Okay, this is the difference between rule instances and data instances.